My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it. 6'2"
Hello,
in a compact.
My name's Dean. This is where you subscribe for daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the price of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is July 28th, 2023, and it's about damn time. It's about damn time we're getting some impulsive, positive price action in the cryptocurrency markets. If you do not know what I'm talking about, then watch until the very end. I hope you're having a great day. Let's get into it. Let's start out with Bitcoin. This, what I just said in the intro, is less obvious in Bitcoin, but you can still see it, all right? Let's zoom out for a second on the daily time frame, and you can see that Bitcoin has been in this mini range here for a few days now, okay? And as I said in a previous episode, this was a breakdown, but not a breakdown completely of this entire range. We're still within the lower limits of this range, right? And when you break a range, when you break down from a range, you can sort of dip below the perceivable support, the lowest perceivable support, and still be within the confines of the range. You're technically not outside of the range, okay? If that makes any sense, right? Because what's likely to happen in this case is that you break back up into the range, right? You hit your head on the midline, and then you continue and you finally break the range. This in Wyckoff theory, right? In Wyckoff accumulation theory is called a spring. Okay, it's very, very common that in a range before the last, like the penultimate or the second to last move of a range before the breakout is a dip below the lowest perceivable support. And what this does essentially, let's switch to the 4-hourly time frame, is it stops anyone thinking like, okay, what it does is, if you think about price being a, let's personify price, for instance, let's think of price as being some sort of entity that is conscious, and it's always seeking liquidity, right? So just like water seeks lower ground, right? Fluids always want to go the path of least resistance in a gravitational system. Same with price, right? There were a lot of people, like the crypto savvies of the world and, like, you know, perma bears, who may have entered some shorts here and may have thought, you know, there's no way this is not breaking down any further. So what happened when the price came down below the perceivable support area is that they probably doubled down, or maybe, you know, entered fresh shorts here, okay? And that is a common occurrence in a range where people who are bearish on a range that's about to break up, an accumulation range, will enter on, you know, the basis that it's going to break down, and then eventually find out that the opposite is occurring. This is just a spring. It's the last move below the perceivable support that's eventually going to result in the price marking up and through the range. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I've talked about this before, so I'm not going to go much more further into it, but that's pretty much, if you're reading this price action on Bitcoin, that's pretty much what's more likely than not to happen. We do not have a crystal ball. Nothing's 100%, but just looking at the price action, looking at what constitutes this mini range that's taken now, this spring or this dip below the perceivable support, is a four-day affair. And what I read in it is 1 degree of A/B basing, 2 degrees of A/B basing, 3 degrees of A/B basing. I see 2 degrees of A/B basing in a pivot, or 3 pairs of flat corrections that should result in this accumulation range being complete, okay? So that's how I'm reading Bitcoin right now. My momentum indicators on the daily time frame concur, right? The daily time frame momentum indicator is crossed bullish right now, and it's completely oversold. 4-hourly support, four-hourly momentum indicators cross bullish in oversold territory. Hourly momentum indicators about to cross bullish, but it's about getting into that oversold territory. It's at the midline. Okay. And my 15-minute, it's completely oversold, you know, and it's cross bullish. I think that this is likely to yield a big move. Now, what corroborates this are two things. The DXY, the US dollar currency index, our main indicator for what Bitcoin and risk on assets are likely to do. You know, you have really strong, rigorous data showing you that the US dollar currency index is inversely correlated to Bitcoin, okay, on a high time frame, and even sometimes more often than not on a small time frame. So let's have a quick look at the US DXY, okay, the US dollar, and what it's been doing. And let's jump out into the hourly time frame. And right, last we spoke, we were talking about this move right here being the what may be the last move that you can see on the chart showing as a direct result of the rates being raised one more time. Okay, despite the rates being raised one more time, what you see here is distributive. This is what I said yesterday, and what we're getting now is confirming that on the charts, because we did start breaking down from this level, checking back again. This is basic 101 trading, charting. If you lose significant support, you have to retest it as resistance before continuing. That's what we're seeing here, right? We came up, we distributed, we channeled, we came down, or we came up a little more, right? And that you would call a spring as well. This is, again, common in ranges. You see springs on the way up, on the way down, right? Above the perceivable, here it's above the perceivable resistance. You spring up, and then it's also called a swing failure pattern. You come down, and then you retest that lost support as resistance. This is what we're doing here. And so this move down, okay, when we get that move down, that should translate into a big move up in crypto, okay, which we're starting to see, as we said, in Bitcoin just a few moments earlier. Okay, and the other thing, so those two, there are two things that are sort of corroborating or confirming or giving credence to the theory that, right, we're starting to move up. The other thing, actually there are three things, but the other really, really encouraging bit is the altcoins, right? And as I said the other day, I'm trading Zilliqa right now, and Zilliqa, since last night, has put in a strong impulse to the upside, okay? Not the strongest, but relatively strong. Checked back, and now is starting up again, okay? And the context of this is, if we zoom out on the 4-hourly time frame, again, you're dealing with a 4-day range that you've been in, right? And that you're looking to leave. Okay, so this is an example of altcoins front-running Bitcoin. So Bitcoin, I showed you this 4-day range for Bitcoin, and that Bitcoin was still at the bottom of its 4-day range and looking to come up, right? Zilliqa and a lot of other altcoins are actually about to break their 4-day range, okay? It's on the brink of breaking that 4-day range and attacking or targeting the next significant resistance, which in the case of Zilliqa is up here somewhere, okay, around 25 cents. So all in all, Zilliqa and a lot of other altcoins are looking to put in a 20% move to the upside, okay? Is that going to happen today? I don't know. May happen today, may happen over the weekend, may happen Monday. I don't know. I have no clue. But it's about damn time that we start getting some impulsive price action to the upside, okay? You know, just go through your watch lists. You can see this throughout the markets, right? A lot of alts, we can take Cardano as well, are starting to break up and out of these channels that they've been in for the past 4 days, as you can see here. Good example, right? 4 day channel, like you're putting in a very nice three wave correction right there, and you're basically consolidating at the bottom of this move on support, and you're looking to break up and out and continue this uptrend, continuing this impulse to the upside. Okay, so that's what it looks like for a lot of altcoins. And I said, yeah, there were two reasons, you know, to corroborate our thesis, but actually there are three. And the third is Bitcoin dominance, right? And I've talked about this before, and you should already know, Bitcoin dominance is a measure of Bitcoin's relative dominance within the entire cryptocurrency space. And if Bitcoin dominance is going down, that means the entire cryptocurrency market, meaning altcoins, which comprise, you know, the majority of the cryptocurrency market, are going up and actually outperforming Bitcoin. And that's what this chart is saying, and it's been consistent, and it should be consistent throughout the duration of the bull market. A proper crypto bull market is when Bitcoin dominance goes down. If Bitcoin dominance is going up, it's a bear market rally. Okay, again, a proper bull market is when Bitcoin dominance goes down, and you can see that here, right? It's been going down ever since late June. And as I said yesterday, this is more likely than not a redistribution, meaning this was an impulse. You consolidated here not to reverse, but to continue. Okay, so it looks as if, right, and this is a daily time frame, each candle represents a day's worth of trading, looks as if this channel is looking to redistribute downwards. That tells us that it's likely that altcoins, Bitcoin, the entire crypto market go to the upside. But in that case, in that instance, you'll have altcoins outperforming Bitcoin, which is what we're seeing. So that's my analysis, guys. Hope that was helpful. Hope that was useful. When this is going to happen, I'm not sure. But just judging, like, I'm paying particularly close attention to Zilliqa, as that's what I'm trading right now. So just by looking at it, it's my sense that this is going to happen sooner than later, because just the way the price action is set up, this channel, this 4 day channel, is basically about to break any moment now. And so this may be something that happens before the end of, you know, trading today, meaning of traditional markets, before 5 p.m. or 5:30 p.m., whenever, the last bell of traditional markets, where the DXY would essentially stop trading. Or we can see this move happen on the weekends, and we've seen that before, and I've talked about that before, that we've had moves in Bitcoin and altcoins that have happened on the weekend. So that's a possibility, even though you don't see it all the time. But keep in mind, what we don't see all the time are impulses to the upside. We've been in a down and sideways market for over 900 days. So we can see it on the weekend. We can see it before the end of trading today. I think those two possibilities are most probable. Okay, the idea that we wait until Monday before seeing any action is unlikely, because why? Monday is the new moon, the first of the month, I believe. I believe it's the first of the month. And remember, a new moon represents a local market bottom. So I believe what's more likely than not to happen is that either today, or a combination of today and the weekend, we do get a move, not just in altcoins, but in Bitcoin, come to the upside. You know, how quick we start moving, I don't know. But one thing I'll say is, when we start moving impulsively, you may not notice it in the first wave, okay? I'm talking Elliott wave theory here, okay? There, Elliott wave impulses happen in five waves, okay? The first wave probably comes... Let's redo this real quick. The first wave is typically only professionals, only really, really careful observers of the market are able to perceive. It's not that apparent. But the third wave is unmistakable. Anybody can tell that's impulsive, okay? That's what is likely to happen. And when we're in impulse, it's really hard to miss. Everybody should be able to tell, okay? When we do go in impulse, one of the characteristics, one of the features of impulsive price action is unmistakable. So we should be able to put in 20% in an hour or something like that, right? So you shouldn't have too many doubts as to whether or not we went impulsive. And so what I'm saying is, if that third wave hits and we're able to go, and when I say third wave, obviously, you know, if you get into the details, the finer points of Elliott wave theory, you understand that there are degrees. So which third wave are you talking about? Are you talking about the third wave here, the third wave here? Like, all right, I'm just saying a substantive third wave that takes us far enough where people are like, oh, we moved. And you see double-digit gainers in your watch list, okay? That may happen before the end of closing today. That may happen over the weekend. But that is more likely than not to happen, in my opinion, before Monday, okay? So that's my... view of the markets. That's what I'm prepared to trade. And guys, coming soon, I'm talking to a few exchanges, might partner with an exchange and be able to provide you all with some exclusive benefits, right? Those of you who follow me, those of you who watch these videos, you may be able to get some nice treats because the bull market is coming and a lot of these exchanges are looking for influencers, reps, you know, partners to promote their exchanges because crypto is about to get really popular once again. So hopefully you're well positioned to get involved before the masses get involved and you're able to profit, right? Because it's been a while. All right, guys, take care. I may or may not see you tomorrow. You know the deal. But until next time, bye. Time for the crime of Les Majesty. And the police, because they can't arrest me. I like to see you wiggle. It makes me dribble. Fancy a fiddle? My money don't jiggle, jiggle. It folds. I like to see you wiggle, wiggle. For sure. It makes me want to dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it. 6'2" in a comp.